Yesterday's session was about the machine learning. Today also I will take some of the concept related to machine learning. First, I think you must remind that what is machine learning. Machine learning is a type of data science. It comes under the category of data science. The only difference how it is differ from different analytics and data analytics and data all this thing, data mining. Mainly here we apply algorithms. When we use algorithms for solving anything, any data problems, that comes under the category of machine learning. Mainly there are two type. It is classified into two categories. One is supervised and the another one is unsupervised. Supervised means we have some idea. So when we are having some idea, that is very good for us. But most of the time we don't have any idea, then we have to that comes under the category of unsupervised algorithm. Okay. So before showing this practically, I will just give you some idea about supervised. Yesterday I have already given. So this all portion is covered. See, now you can see there are two types of fruits. One is apple and the another one is banana. Okay, both are having some there is no similarity between both. Means they are just one similarity is that they are fruits. They come under the category of fruits. But if I will keep one more fruit, orange, suppose orange, take it as orange. So in which category you think it belongs? I think most of the people will keep with it with apple. See, consider this as a two different types. One is a banana is a different category and apple is a different category. And one new fruits has been come and he has to belong into any of them. Or even it can create its own cluster also. But most of the time it is not good that you are making a cluster after entering each and every element. So it is better just take out some similarity between them and try to form in that previous cluster only. Okay, so orange hai. So if we consider orange, in which group it belongs? It belongs to A, apple or banana. Most of the people will put it into the apple category. Why? Because it is something looks little round and its shape is similar to somewhat orange, somewhat apple. So in that case, you have find the similarity. So just this is the example of clustering. You form a one cluster. So you have to explore your mind. Explore your mind means you have to think beyond the imagination. Means you have to do some statistical analysis. See, what I am saying, that cannot be applied practically. Practically, it is totally maths based. Maths based means we have to use some algorithms that is mainly used our brain functionality like KNN algorithm. What it takes, it basically calculate the distance between the new object and the old group object and which one is less, that particular new object will belongs to that category. Okay, so this is another formation. You can see there are blue cross and there are something red dots. Okay, now there is some one line. That line is mainly, if I explain you about support vector machine, this support vector machine classification algorithm has created this line. What it do, it tries to separate the blue from the red. But it is not 100% accurate. You can see some of the red cross are already entered with the some of the blue cross are entered with the red dots. So this is not 100% separation is not possible, but we have to try as we can do, as best we can do. Okay, means you have to use your statistical analysis means linear equation, non-linear equation. Many times it happens that there is no relation between x and y, and you, anyway you have to find the relation between x and y. Okay, I will give an example. You people have heard about regression problem. See, regression problem is mainly some sort of function, mathematical function that tries to develop a relation between the data points. How that I will show you. Just see, there are two parameters. One is x, another one is y. Y is totally depend on the value of x. If x is equal to 0, y is equal to 0. If x equal to 0.5236, y is 1.5. Means after this, if someone asks you what will be the value of x, what will be the value of y at 3.146, you have to show some relation. Means you have to carry out some relation between x and y. This is known as model. What this relation formation is known as model, and this is only approved when you calculate the accuracy. In this short span of time, I cannot explain you that what is accuracy. I can just give you idea on the basis of accuracy. If this model which you have developed that gives the accuracy of almost 80% or 90%, we can say that this model is good. If it is not giving the proper output, if it is not giving the proper output, means this normal, this model is not worth for us. So you have to form the relation. See how you form. See, you have already seeing the value of x and y. Means if this is something tough, I will give you an easy example. See, x is equal to 0, y is equal to 4. X is equal to 1, y is equal to 5. X equal to 2, y is equal to 6. What you have seen, whatever the value of x, that will be incremented by plus 4 in case of y. Means you have formed the relation that y is equal to x plus 4. This is your model. So whenever a new value comes, you can predict the value of y. Okay. I think I have cleared this something. What is regression? Regression means mainly you have to form the relation between x and y. Okay. Yesterday we cannot cover this concept. Unsupervised learning, conceptually different problem. No information about correct outputs are available. No regression, no guess. Means there is no idea about anything. Means if you are doing analysis for the first time, you don't know what to do, what approach I has to follow. Because mainly anything has been done for the first time, that is the type of unsupervised learning. Means you don't have an idea what it gives, what result will come, what techniques I have to apply, and whether the result which you have accessed or whether the result which you have generated, that is correct or not. That is the big issue. See, if you said you are right, but it has to give the proper output for the another input also. If it is giving, that means you are right. Otherwise, it will be a total waste of your time. Okay. This is some diagram related to your classification, machine classification algorithms. There are, see, you people don't be afraid of this terms. Actually, machine learning is a very vast. You cannot learn in 2 or 3 days. Even data science cannot be learned in 2 or 3 days. You must have little idea about Python or R or MATLAB or Java. After that only you can move to the data science or machine learning. These are the very I will not say that this is very tough, but we cannot learn in just 2 or 3 days. Okay, you must keep in mind, I can just give you simple idea about data science and machine learning and all these things, but you have to, if you work for at least 30 to 40 or 50 or 60 days, if you make some mini project, then you get more idea. And of course, believe me, if you prepare for at least 40 or 50 days, you will get a very good job. Okay, you because by reading in 2 or 3 days, you will get little idea. But after some time, after 10 or 15 days, if someone asks you that what is machine learning or what is data science, I don't think that you people will be able to answer. So you have to do lot of practice. Means you have to work for at least 10 days, 40 days, 50 days, 60 days. Means I think you have to, in my opinion, if you ask, you have to work for at least 6 months. So that you will be able to get a very good job in the field of machine learning. Okay. Before this, I will just explain you. Reinforcement learning. See, it is something that is lies between the unsupervised and supervised. See, we have some idea, but the idea which we have, we cannot say that actual that idea which we have received that is totally correct. On the basis of which we have to do some analysis. See, there are three things in which we have better idea means this has happened and it is 100% true and you have to work just like this. This is supervised learning. Another one, second one, there is no idea and you have to move on. That is the unsupervised. Third one is there are some results, but we cannot say that this result are accurate and we cannot rely totally on this result which we have accessed some previous analysis. On the previous analysis, this comes under the category of reinforced learning. Okay, now back to our coding portion. I will just want to show that how yesterday I couldn't able to complete it. This time I will complete it. Before that, I would like to take some questions from you people. If you have some questions, okay. I think nobody has question. Okay. Okay. Now I will tell you the code and all this thing. See, this is a code. This code, what's showing? In this, we are creating one data set. Okay. You can see these are the libraries numpy import matplot import lib and operator. All these are the some library which we have, and we have to create a data set. We are creating a data set. Okay, now in this data set, we already created this data set in the form of an array. In array, there are total 8 elements. There are total 8 elements. These elements are these elements are 1, 1.1, 0, 0. Like this, and we have labels. Means we already said that there will be two type of cluster. One will be the A or the classification algorithm A, or another one will be the B. Okay, label A and label B. Now it shows the groups at the values. Means there are four arrays, 1, 1.1, 1.0, 1.0, 0.0, 0.1, and there are only two groups. One is A and one is B. You can easily tell from just viewing this. You can see that out of this, where one belongs, definitely zero will not belongs to that A group. Where 0 belongs, 1 will not be belongs to that group. Means 1 and 1.1 belongs to A group. In that case, 0 and 0.1 belongs to B group. Okay? Am I clear? I will just show you. See, what you have to do. What you have to do. I just prepare a code ready-made. Because otherwise, it will take more time. See, I'm just hiding this code. How to use comments here. Just put inverted comma. This means this has been hidden. Means you have to work. This 5 lines are visible to the, and we are just executing this. Okay. I think most of the. This is the screen where you have to write, and this is the area. This console where we will basically write the code. Code is here, and we will write the command. Okay. I'm just running this program. Okay. Is some error. Okay. Yeah. Now it's working. See, it shows the error, syntax error, end of file, because I have put the comments in the upper half, but I didn't put the comments in the lower half. Lower below side, that's why it is not running. If it runs, it will just look like this, what it is showing. Okay, means that upper 5 lines will be executed. What it gives, see, I will just use show you. See, what we are trying to display here, we will just group the, we will just show, first I will import this py file. What you have to write, import KNN. Actually, first I have created a data set and I saved it in the form of, in the name of knn.py. You can save it any name, you can save it in your name also. Means you have created the, this data set and this is known as knn.py. Okay, and remember one thing, you have to save this file in the same folder where you have saved the Anaconda. Okay, now I will show how it works. This is your first command. Okay, that means it is perfectly working. What it did, it just import the file. You can see here, there is knn.py, iris.py, that is some another file, knn.py. Okay, I will just delete it, otherwise you people get confused. knn.py, and I import this file. I import this file into my Python console. Okay, this is basically we have to say. Now labels and groups. This will create the data set. See, this has created the data set. Now see, remember one thing, what we have did, first you have to import that file, that Python file, and you have create the data set for that file. Okay, now just enter it. What happens, that groups and labels both will have this data set, and what it do, it will show both one by one. First it will display the group, just you have to write group. It is showing the group, means showing the group means what are the member this array consists. Another one is labels. Labels are AABB. That means that 1.1.1.1 that belongs to AA, and 00 and 00.1 belongs to BB. It is that is showing what we have already initialized. See, this is the KNN algorithm. We can say that we have practically implemented KNN data set. First, we have created a data set and we are practically implementing KNN algorithm. This is just the logic. Okay, now I am deleting, removing this comments. I will show you that what it shows. See what this this rest of the commands will show. What this shows, see, it first create the matrix. See, first it will create the matrix. We will pass one file. See, it might be little tough for you people. This code cannot be covered in this 1 hour or half an hour. This what I will just explain you within one line. What it do, it basically what file, whatever the file we are giving, that is totally convert in the form of matrix. That is the simple, only as simple as that. I already copied the code. You can see this code. See, remember one thing, in Python indentation is very very necessary. You must follow the indentation. We cannot do like this in for loop that we can open the curly braces from anywhere. Here you have to maintain a tab space. You people can see that whenever I am defining any function or defining anything, you people can see that I am when I am defining any function, I am definition is right from after one tab space. I am maintaining a tab space. Okay, same way when we are declaring any when we are executing any for loop, you are maintaining a tab space for the for loop body. Same, you always remember that there must be some sort of indentation. Okay, I think I have little bit, you get the idea. In this, you are just what you are doing, you are just converting your file after into the matrix form. After that, you are opening the file and you are performing the operations. Operations will be look like this. I will show you just within a moment what all things you can do. You can just import it again. You want to reload it, there is no need of it if you don't want to reload. what are you doing? See, this third, you can see three lines. First, input KNN, reload KNN. Now, this is the very important line. What you are doing here, you are taking one text file. Last time, whatever the file you have taken in the previous classes, they are common separated values. Means most of the time, they are just like an Excel file. You have taken the text file. What you have taken the? You have taken the text file and you are converting that file in the form of matrix, in the form of just we can say, I will just show you. Wait a moment. First, I will just execute. I will show you what it gives the display. Oh, it's input KNN, the same code which I have written here. I am writing the same code, reload. Is taking some time. Don't know why it is giving error. I will just explain you why, what is it. Afterwards, I will show you the output. See, what it is doing, it is mainly creating the labels. Third line is showing creating the labels for the dating test set. Dating test set is a text file, and you are forming the first, it will convert into matrix. You can easily see, you people, that it is first convert into the form of matrix. First it convert in the form of matrix, that text file, then it is, it form the labels, then it form the labels, and you can display the 20 values of that text, and you can plot the graph with the help of matplotlib. You can do whatever you like to do. It will shows the output in the form of graph. You will get this slide, believe me, it will be executed. I don't know that there may be some problem. But it will definitely get executed. It will, what it shows, it shows the graph. It shows the graph that will form a cluster, and the cluster will have some small 20 points. If you want to see 100 points, you can just write here 100 points. Out of this text file, 100 dots will be shown, and that will form a cluster that shows you, basically that where that cluster formation is good or not. See, if all the elements are tightly coupled, means they are related to there is a short distance between them, that cluster is good. But if there is separation between the elements and you are forming a cluster, we cannot say that this is a good cluster. In that case, you have to do repetition number of times, you have to do analysis, and you have to compile it. Okay, I think I have to, you people can ask me some questions.